Hello, everybody. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Joyce Charlie. Today, I want to share with you the vision that I was shown about Donald Trump. I was shown because I am sometimes when I pray I'm shown things, and these visions that I see in the prayers are very, very important, because I never take them for granted. But before I share this testimony, before I want to share another vision that I saw for about 2 years ago about someone else. This vision that I so much connect to the death of this man here. This man here, his name is Bernard Membe, who is Tanzanian politician. When I was praying, I was shown this guy here. And this guy here, maybe then I shall start to talk about who he is. This guy here is a Tanzanian journalist. He is Tanzanian journalist. He is activist. He is also Tanzanian journalist, but he is also, he was in those days, he was a great supporter of Magufuli. He was, he liked it. He was posting, he's a supporter of the government. He always posts, he always talk about him to support government, to support Magufuli those days. So this is what I know. He was telling people, let's support Magufuli because he is a good, he is has a good read. So I discover his channel in 2020. For me, he is a very patriot man, and I think that he is always fighting for that the government should vote for, get support, so people have, everyone was opposing Magufuli, but Magufuli was doing a great job, and this is what he was mostly occupied by. In 2020, this is when I discovered his channel. His channel is called Tanzania TV. He is also having a newspaper. I don't know if he still has the news. His newspaper was called Tanzania newspaper. But I discovered his channel in 2020, that time when he was posting things, because that time it was when Magufuli was running to become a president, was running again for the next term. And that time I was, because I was a follower of Magufuli, I was a team Magufuli, and I was following Magufuli so much. So I was looking for information about how the election going in Tanzania, and that's why I discovered his channel. And I was following every day when what he was posting. There was a lot of things he was following live when Magufuli was sending live. But the very, very interesting things was that he was posting about, he was showing what Magufuli has done. It was a lot of things that Magufuli has done. And me, myself, I was so much saying, wow, that the country has changed totally. Everything has changed. Country has become totally like a new country. Almost it changed everything. Because Magufuli has been a great job. I'm going to talk about this in another video about Magufuli. I will also tell you about you. My relationship I had with Magufuli and the other things. So stay tuned to the next another video. But today I was talking about what I was shown, and so that time Cyprian Msiba was showing things like how this is a time when I discovered also this guy whose name is Bernard Membe. That was the time when I discovered him. I don't know so much about him either than how I didn't know so much about him either before, because this guy also, he was running to become president in parallel to the Magufuli. And so, no. ACT was Orlando, while Magufuli was running through CCM. Also, Cyprian Msiba, he was, those days, through his channel, he was like it, he was doing promotion for Magufuli because he was posting a lot about Magufuli. He was posting live wherever Magufuli was going, and we were following. So, to be honest, I liked his channel so much that I was looking, watching every time this, when he was running to become. So I was watching it very, very a lot, and many times when I thought that it was giving a lot of information, and that is, and also I got to know Cyprian Msiba through that, because he was the one who was running that his channel, and together with other people. So what is something I say is that this channel, after Magufuli, when I was, because it, so this man here, Cyprian Membe, I was following up a little bit about what he was talking and so on. Even if he had some kind of points, but most of the points he was on, I thought it was so deception. I did not want to continue to follow him or to listen. At that time, only I was following mostly Magufuli, but sometimes this, and remember, was speaking a lot of things that people, everyone was thinking that it was a deception. And then after he disappeared from in the middle of election, he disappeared. And the people say that last time he was seen at the airport, blah, 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 blah. And so people started to wonder where he is, some kind of, why he is not continuing to go around. When at that time Magufuli was going everywhere, the other oppositions also were going everywhere, but the member has disappeared. And so it was known that he went to Dubai. So this is something about, this is something I knew. But when he came back, so the people catch him at the airport and they ask him, where have you been? He said that I was in Dubai because there I have some business I'm doing, and because he was some kind of very strange. That business I'm doing, and because I wanted to finish my business because I know now I'm coming to become president. You become president, you haven't run the promotion, you haven't done anything. What do you think you can become a president of some kind of? So this is it. So people thought he was very strange, and who was he was talking to, and what he did, and so much more. So no, but actually, this is how I knew Membe, and this is how I could say what I could say about him. But in 2021, 2022, after Magufuli was dead, then I heard something else about, this is what I thought, and also, almost every word Magufuli was speaking was point on point, as I can say that. And this is something about that. Magufuli was a man that he followed the order, and he is a man who was totally against corruption, and he was a man who loved his job, and he always says that leadership is sacrifice, and something like I remember so much about him. But so in my prayer, I was 2 years ago, I was praying. I was praying about totally other things, and suddenly I saw Cyprian, this guy here, Cyprian Msiba, on my vision. And when I saw him, I say, wow, I see Cyprian Msiba. What's happening with Cyprian Msiba? This is something about that. And then I was sitting and thinking, and then it came into my thought that I remember Cyprian Msiba was actually having a big debt, because after when Magufuli was dead, this is something was I saw online that the court has ruled that Cyprian Msiba has to pay this guy here, his name is Bernard Membe, has to pay him 9 billion Tanzania shilling or go to jail because of he wrote a report that this Bernard Membe means that say that he destroyed his reputation. So this is what I knew, and that time, even in my prayer, I did not know I knew a little bit that Cyprian Msiba, what he was occupied by, and most of the time he was sometimes exposing the enemies he said the enemies of our country, some kind of, because he loved so much, he loved country, he loved Tanzania, and he loved to see that things. So something like this, all the enemies of Magufuli, and because he loved Magufuli, so he exposed them by telling that they were, because that time Membe and Magufuli, they were in the same party. Membe and they were in the same party. And he exposed them that they wanted to take Magufuli out of election in 2020 so that this guy here could run through CCM. But then after he was exposed, they said that he said that they are getting help from outside the country. Some people were helping. I don't know who they are. And in 2020, you know, so after that, I heard that, because then after I had to follow up on YouTube to follow up more, to learn more about it. So that was, I heard that this member was kicked out of their party together with the people that had arbitrariness. Like Membe, there are some people also who were betraying Magufuli that were exposed together with him. They were all kicked out of the party. And this is something that I just heard, and even if, I don't know how they were planning to remove Magufuli from running. Because I also knew that Magufuli had many enemies, understand? Even if he was doing, his people thought that he was doing right, but outside the country, they did not like him. But this is something about, after when I saw him, I remembered his death. So I started to pray for him. I told God everything about what Cyprian Msiba was going through. But also I told Magufuli, this party that is the ruling party now could not come into power. At least I say that the great help come from this. It was him who did great promotion for them, understand? So we think that for me it was so unfair what he was going through. I didn't, that time, I don't know if we got any help later, I don't know, but to go that through without any help. At the end of the time, he ended up that he has to pay so much money, or nobody can help. Okay, that is how things are. But I was praying to God that God could help him, or to God to push his enemies away. In that time, because that's to say that when I was praying, I pray for my, so that time I told God, Lord, push away his enemies, because help him, because I felt that he doesn't deserve that, because for how it is so totally unfair that he has to go through this. And I was sitting and I was thinking, I was thinking about a lot of things that was happening in Tanzania especially after death of Magufuli. But I was thinking I was feeling like there are things that were not right. But I was thinking, so I got so very emotional and I was thinking about, and so it appeared in front of me that it was this text, just like when you are watching TV or watching on computer. It was a text in front of me that say, "Be strong and courage, for nothing is hidden in the eyes of the Lord." But after I hear that, I knew that God will do something, even if I didn't know what he could do. But I knew that something would be done, even if I didn't know what was that. So now I come to that Then it was about 1 week, one, it was a 3 days, some kind of, I cannot remember if it went 1 week or 3 days, but it was not so very long. I was sleeping. And early in the morning, I woke up and the power of God was coming, was so strong that I was feeling like I was kind of, I was not able to breathe because it come with great power, like aggressiveness and power. I cannot understand. I decided to sit. I will continue to pray. And that time when I was praying, so I just was thinking about, I remember, remind God about Sibas. But I was praying about something else. And I came across, I said to pray for Tanzania, pray for Mama Samia, Suluhu, because at that time it was like the, not always I pray for Mama Samia, sometimes I do that, especially that time because when I was praying for, it was political things. So I was praying for Mama Samia. I said, please, Lord, strengthen Mama Samia, help her. And so, please, there are things that Mama Samia, especially Mama Samia, has announced that I had announced that because Tanzania until today, homosexuality is not allowed. Women is not recognized as gender in Tanzania. Women that it's only two genders that are created by God. Both religions has accepted that. But there are some people who were trying, were used by people. So I was telling God there are people who are used by people outside that they are trying to convince the government or to bring some threats. So sometimes they bring to make this law to make this law to be changed. So I pray, Lord, to help to strengthen Mama Samia, who has already declared that he is not going to change anything, and help him. So this is something I was praying. And I was also praying for Mama Samia that she could get strength and other things that were necessary for her to continue to lead something kind. So when I continued to pray, then I was taken into the, I saw myself like it was like in my thoughts, but I was suddenly, I was found myself, I was like I was in front of or in the parliament building in Tanzania, and I hear the voice of a woman, who a woman minister that I know who she is, like, where were you to bring it, to bring it back, some kind of. So I told God, I hear some voice that is telling that they are going to bring it back, that they are going to change things, like. So I ask God to rebuke that, I ask rebuke that voice and ask God to silence that voice in Jesus' name. To be honest, until today, Tanzania is a homosexual free, which I think is good in my perspective, that because I believe that this law is destroying humanity. People must be told the truth that there are two genders, and those people who need help, they shall get help that is really help than to destroy the whole people because of problems of a few people. After that, I finished my prayer and I went, I sit, and later when I was sitting, I came to social media. I opened social media. Then I came across Membe has passed away. Membe, this guy here, has passed away. So I decided to follow up to say that why Membe has passed away. So when I follow up, then so there are so many things that some people started to say maybe Cyprian Nusiba has killed him. Some people say maybe he was. But according to how I was listening to very honest people, especially his driver, say that last day he was very, very healthy and very, very much. He had meeting very early in the morning so he could go to, he told him to come to pick him up early in the morning so he could go to the meeting. But then, early in the morning, it started like he was not, he couldn't breathe. He was a problem with the breathing. So they took him to the ICU before anything, so he was already passed away. So this was the news. And at this time, I remember that power that fell down early in the morning. It was so aggressive that it made me like I was not able to breathe. I know this story is so much, but don't worry. After that, actually, so when I was following, listening to many, when what people say, so I went to his Instagram. So I saw on Instagram he had posted that his last video he was making a lot of threat against this guy, Cyprian Sibba. He was going to silence him, to make sure that he will never, never, ever again speak things, do that. He meant that it was stupid things he was doing. He will make sure he will never do that. At the same time, I also heard that there was some people, because he started to climb, to send videos that climbing, that Cyprian Sibba shall pay him as soon as possible. And 39 billion, yeah. At the same time, I also hear that there was some a man who is a bishop, because a member is a Christian. Cyprian Sibba is also Christian. There is a man who is a bishop. He tried to call him and ask him, you know what, why can't you just forgive him? Because we know that this man is too much. Because even if he becomes, at least reduce the amount, or just let it, because even if he becomes sold, or his entire village will be sold, still there will be not enough money to get to pay the debt. Because the court has ruled that all his properties must be sold so that the member could be paid this money. And this is something about that. You see? But then a member passed away very early in a very situation that it was very circumstances that nobody can even explain. Even doctors or anyone cannot explain the reason of his death. So this is something about I was shown. To be honest, I have never shared this to anyone until today, because I was thinking that how can I start to talk this? It was something that, how can I start? How can I really start? But, so, a few days when I was praying, 2 days, so I'm talking about what I saw about Donald Trump. What I saw about Donald Trump, it was, you know, this is why, when I see people, there are some people that I'm praying or I'm helping, and I'm praying like crazy for them, and I'm praying for them, and I'm only to ask them to be obedient, it becomes like I'm asking too much. I'm just trying to warn them that you should be very careful, because sometimes even when I say I get out of this, it's because I know that I shall not continue to support someone who is rebelling God. You know that when you are, when I give you some instructions, you should do. It is a fear that makes me to say that, fear of God, I mean. And fear of what I know that can be so dangerous. Because I feel like you're walking, dealing with fire. You're playing with fire. And maybe you feel like you don't know. When I give you instruction, when I tell you that God has promised to protect you, and you're going to take something else from another God, and you wear it, and you be proud that you mean that that is something you are wearing on your hand will protect you. You mean that is your protection. Do you know this you're doing is a total abomination to God? It is playing with fire. You know, if God has left you, who can, do you think that there is nothing, something you can do? And I'm here to help, and I'm doing whatever that it takes to help. I'm praying, and you never follow instructions. not so ever. And you just live like always you complain about freedom. I understand that you complain so much about freedom. Like for me, you make me feel like I'm stopping you from your freedom. You talk so much about freedom, like that some people died for your freedom. But remember, without God, that freedom could not be celebrated. So the first someone to celebrate is God, not those statues you have on your hand. And you praise those who say that these are the things that they protect you. Really? You'll be protected. So you're telling me that you have chosen that Hindu God instead of choosing the true God that it has become so generous and to try to help you. Do you think you are different from you and Membe? Who is better? Do you think you are better than Membe? My prayers is that you change. My prayers is that you understand that this is serious. My prayer is that you follow instructions that I'm giving to you so that God can help you to go further. For me, it doesn't help anything if you won't change. So I'm going to talk about what I saw about Donald Trump, because also God has shown me something about Donald Trump in January, that Donald Trump is coming. And I was ordered to pray for him also.
2 days ago,
Donald Trump, I saw him. I saw when I was praying, and then Donald Trump appeared. And when Donald Trump appeared, I saw that Donald Trump was some kind of sitting on. And then I saw him like in the room. And in that room, it just seemed like it was office. His office, perhaps. In the office, over his chair, there was some kind of malaria. I don't know if there is malaria over his chair. I don't know, but it was looking like malaria. And over that malaria, there was something like that. Over that chair, there was something dark. That I cannot even explain if it is malaria or it is anything, but it was something like I think maybe something has been put over his chair, over on the wall, or something was over him to destroy him. And I think that this is a power, evil power, that was that. But I'm just trying, I prayed about it, and I asked God to remove that evil power. I'm just trying to give Donald Trump that I am praying for him, and he shall not be afraid. He shall not be afraid. They cannot destroy you with anything. They cannot destroy you with evil powers, I mean, witchcraft or anything will not prevail. And I know for sure that God has placed you for the very great mission and very great reason that you shall take this country to the next level, both spiritually and economically and everything. So continue to fight for what is right, and pray. I continue to pray for you, and according to how I was ordered in January. So this is my message that I'm trying to give, and I'm going to send this video directly to him also to show him that this is what I've been shown. May God help Donald Trump. In the name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I'm praying. I thank you so much. I have finished to post this, and because I praying for Donald Trump. I pray for the strength. I pray for him to be strengthened and to help him to continue to take this country, the United States, in the next level. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that Donald Trump shall be given wisdom and more wisdom, and I bind any kind of evil power, antichrist powers, to not prevail and to get out of his way in Jesus' mighty name. And he shall be a great leader in this time, in the name of Jesus. Amen. So